What's up, musicians? I'm back with another review, this time for the best budget MIDI keyboard. So let's go. Now, there are a ton of MIDI controllers out there under $100, and if you're beginning in music production, that could be a little overwhelming. So I already did a review of my favorite MIDI controller, the Korg NanoKey Studio, but at $150, that could be a big investment, especially if you're just getting started. Now, I've tested almost every cheap MIDI controller out there, and they should all pretty much do the same thing. They should have about 25 keys, some faders and knobs, and some drum pads for finger drumming. They should also be USB powered, so you don't have to lug around any batteries. And my absolute favorite budget MIDI controller is this, the Akai MPK Mini. It comes in a ton of fun colors like this one that looks like a keyboard Darth Vader would use, and you can usually find it for $99 or below. I think I got mine for around 80. But if you buy it new, you'll get some free software like the VST Synth Hybrid and Wobble, which, to be honest, I don't really use. It also comes with MPC Essentials, but I really don't recommend the MPC software if you're just getting started. I personally use Ableton Live, but I find even GarageBand is more intuitive and user-friendly for beginners. But if you're old school and have already been making beats on an MPC, then sure, that's a bonus. But the included software is not the reason to get this. So if you can find it used for cheap, you should. Because the number one reason I love this controller is because it feels great to play. The keys are mini, sure, but they're a lot bigger than some of the other keyboards out there.
And the springs make the keys a lot of fun to play. Cool. Other keyboards I've tried have felt gummy or not responsive.
It's also built like a tank. Sure, it's still plastic, but it feels great to play, and I've tossed this into my backpack plenty of times with no protection and it's held up great.
Even the NanoKey Studio's keys can feel a little bit delicate, with the odd key mechanism sometimes getting stuck if you hit it at the wrong angle. But the MPK Mini's keyboard feels like a full-size keyboard, just shrunk down. Let's go over some of the features. You get 25 velocity-sensitive keys and 8 velocity-sensitive backlit pads.
These are by far my favorite pads to play with, so much in fact that I ended up buying the MPD 218, which are 16 of the same pads on a super slim device, until I realized that the MPK's 8 pads are really all I need. And even though you only have 8 physical pads, this button here lets you switch between pad banks, so you can actually assign 16 samples, or 8 samples per bank. You have an arpeggiator with a bunch of different presets you can control by holding down the on-off button and the desired key, as well as a tap tempo button that sets this internal clock that you can hit if you aren't controlling the tempo through your DAW. Note repeat is an interesting function that I personally don't get a lot of use out of, but it could be fun, especially if you're jamming live. You can hold down the arpeggiator's on-off button and hit the key with your desired note value, and you can have some real fun.
There's also this XY joystick, which is a unique approach to the pitch bend and modulation wheels.
So here I have the X controlling the pitch and the Y controlling the cutoff filter in Ableton's native analog instrument. Over on the other side of the pads, you have these 8 mini knobs, and under the knobs, you have a few pad controls. These are a bit more involved than would be useful for the beginner, but in short, when the control change button is enabled, the pads will send MIDI values instead of notes. And program change lets you use the pads to switch between banks or presets. And finally, the program select lets you switch between preset defaults of the entire controller you set up in the MPK Mini Editor software, which again is getting into the weeds of everything this thing can do, but that's part of the reason I love it. It comes with a great set of super functional features that are easy to use, but it also has the capability of being useful for a professional setup.
There's a lot you can do with the MPK Mini, but for me it all comes down to feel. Is it fun to play with? And the answer is yes. And while it may lack all the bells and whistles of some of the more expensive models, the MPK Mini is the best bang for the buck if you want to spend under $100. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. And if you like my videos and want to see more, consider purchasing some gear through the links below, or donate.